thing that we were divided into three groups. One group was led by Monsignor Jerry, the other group by Archbishop Ramon Argeles, and the third group led by me. And our group, after a tour in the morning in a place, until mid-afternoon, late afternoon, we went to the Cathedral of Chanlong. And there we first celebrated the Mass. I was the presider, and what is funny is that I was the video, the Vietnamese priest is the audio. Meaning say, I do the action, he says the words. I do not know in your case. English Mass. Ours is Vietnamese Mass. So we were taught the prayer, the beginning, the sign of the cross. The Our Father, the Hail Mary, the Glory Be, but not the whole Mass. So I was taught the sign of the cross and the greeting. After that, the Vietnamese priest took over in the voice. I do the action. So after the Mass, we were brought to the different classrooms near the cathedral where the catechism were held. And this is what I learned. I think this is true of the whole of the diocese. There are four levels. Now, each level has two classes a week. Friday, Saturday, or Saturday, Sunday. Usually weekends. And each session has 1.5 hours. Level one are those who are prepared for confession and First Communion for 3 years. For 3 years. So every week they have a session. And each session, as I have said, 1.5 hours. The second level is prepared for confirmation for 3 years. The same, 2 days a week, 1.5 hours per session. The fourth level is living the gospel for 3 years. Same number of sessions and same number of hours. And the fourth level is vocation. Here, they are helped to discern their vocation. Also 3 years. So those who feel for married life, after some time they are separated. Those who are filled to be called to the religious life, consecrated life, the priesthood are separated, and they are prepared for their vocation. No wonder there are many seminarians and priests in Vietnam because of that. As Monsignor Jerry said, in the seminary of Quan Long, for dioceses, they have 500 seminarians. In San Carlos, not even 200. So, but about half of that are philosophers, and the other half are theologians, and they finish college already. And this is how they give formation to their catechists. Those who teach in the first level are taught by their parish priest. The parish priest is the first formator in catechism. Then those who teach in the second level, confirmation, is taught in the deanery. Deanery means vicariate. So the catechists are grouped together and the priests help one another to teach them. Now the third and the fourth level are done diocesan. Diocesan, so parish. So the parish priests are really involved. Then the vicariates and then the diocese. No wonder they have many volunteers. And when we asked one catechist whether they are paid, tumawa na lang siya. So we asked, why do you volunteer? Well, she said, I love to teach children. The other said, it's my apostolate. So no wonder. But a little bit of background about communism. So the communists, the government there is communist. And there is a difference I learned between the communism of Mao Zedong and the communism of Ho Chi Minh. In Mao Zedong, total ban no religious instruction, confiscate everything, the church, the schools, the hospitals. Well, the communists in Ho Chi Minh, yes, they confiscated the hospitals and the schools without funding. For example, the sisters of the SPC, I asked them, have they refunded? No, they have not. But Ho Chi Minh said, respect the religion of the people, respect them. But they do not allow religion to be taught in the schools outside, only within the compound of the parish church. That's why the parishes have the schools for children. And the catechism is not just for regular students. They have also catechism for those who like to be converted. Most of those who like to be converted are Buddhists. Some Protestants. Others, what they call syncretic, pinaghalo actually of religion. So there are also classrooms for those who like to be converted. And of course, these are adults already. And some of them are of age already. I said, I hope we can do that in the Philippines. One, the parish priest is involved in teaching the catechism. They teach the catechism in their parish, one level. And then the vicary also get involved, second level. And then saka pa lang sa diocese. And that is our plan in Caloocan, right? But instead of parish level, we'll begin at the vicariate level. All the parish priests in that vicariate will get them involved. So we'll ask for volunteer who likes to be catechist. And now we have, probably we have 2 years of formation and very few survive. So we will train it down to 3 months. And we will have a ready syllabus before, no ready syllabus. And then if they like to continue, 1 year of formation. So that is our plan in Caloocan to the help of Father Amado Hino, Bongino from the Archdiocese of Manila. But now he is in the Diocese of Caloocan. Doon pala siya talaga. Doon pala siya incarcerated. Pinabalik ko, bumalik ka na rito, kailangan ka namin, bumalik naman. So I am impressed by the catechetical ministry, and it is because of adversity. We take it for granted, we can teach our public school students, it is in our constitution, and very few volunteers. And the students we are teaching in the public schools are not even listening, isn't it? Ingay-ingay. Magulo pa. So, but they pay attention in the classroom, so we observe some catechism, they are silent, and they pay attention. So, finally I ask them, what is the rate of survival, 70%. Meron rin naman nagbaback out after some time. And that is about 30%. But 70% is a good number. No, kahit 60% or even half-half. But 70% is a good number. No wonder they have a lot of seminarians and a lot of priests. So that's what I like to share with you.